Plutonian was still asleep, or should I say, deep in his unconscious state of mind, in an elusive constructed fantasy, he was able to lock himself mentally away. But the consequences of this action put him in a position of him not being able to differentiate between reality and his dream-like state of consciousness. Anthony Daniel Hartigan was afraid that someone will recognize him as the Plutonian, as he disguised himself with the help of Auroran. Forgetting himself that he has no powers, he wanted to interfere in a robbery of a jewelry store, but Auroran stopped him, letting him know that he doesn't have to be a hero anymore, that he is free to live a normal life. And Auroran took care of the criminals robbing the jewelry store. While in reality, in Genom, at the center of the sun, the Plutonian still remained numb. And no matter how much the residents of this place tried to revive him, there was no response. He was so non-responsive that some of the Nazi residents of Genom tried to molest him sexually. Under the supervision of Kaidan, the new recruits were helping to build and reconstruct the Paradigm's headquarters. Now, not so surprising, they were having the idea of getting rid of the survivor and the Paradigm. But Kaidan, who heard their conversation, told them to perish the thought, for there will be consequences. Burroughs, an Esper, who is a hypnotic, telepathic, psychic villain and has the capability to read people's minds, but not only that, he also had the ability to project and merge his mind with any individual, which makes him present physically. And he also feels and smells the surrounding of each individual he is trying to read. He is as close to someone with paranormal abilities. You should understand that Burroughs is evil. He once mentally forced an entire town to commit mass suicide. But the people's minds he was being forced to read by our hero, survivor, made his own crimes look like pickpocketing. He was forcefully given amnesty by survivor and making him read the minds of new recruits to the Paradigm, who were villains like himself, or should I say worse. In this, survivor wanted to know who is genuine. Going back to the Plutonian's constructed world, Anthony Dan Hartigan was on a date with his one-time girlfriend Alana Patel, who made him understand that he knows and remembers him as the Plutonian, and that she forgives him for everything. But suddenly, just right where Alana Patel is sitting was the enigmatic Modius, asking Anthony Dan Hartigan for a fresh start, and that he should face the truth and look inside of himself. As one Modius became multiple Modiuses, and they pushed Anthony Dan Hartigan off a tall building in the restaurant he was in. As he falls endlessly, Auroran advised him to wake up from his sleep state. It was torture for Burroughs, for he was being present physically in the minds of these repentant villains, for they were way worse than him, and this rattled his mind psychologically, for he could feel and see every pain they caused in the past, and this was draining him physically. It was exhausting. Imagine seeing crime scenes after crime scenes, which were unspeakable even for Burroughs. As our hero survivor doesn't care, he just wants answers to know if he can trust his new recruits to the Paradigm. Luckily enough for Burroughs, Qubit came in with a device he called an Esper Coder, which can track whatever Burroughs is gleaning or obtaining mentally from each individual. At first, the survivor objected, for he thinks it was a waste of his time. But when Qubit flattered his ego, he succumbed to Qubit's idea of placing the device on Burroughs. But Qubit lied. The truth is, the device he was putting on the wrist of Burroughs was a resonator, which will help Burroughs in blocking out horrible crimes he was observing by merging his mind with these individuals. As Qubit was communicating telepathically with Burroughs, asking for his help in him reading the mind of the survivor. At first, Burroughs objected to the idea, but Qubit convinced him that he believes Survival has a personal agenda, and the world might have traded the devil they know from the angel they don't know. So Burroughs enter the mind of Survival, and true to Cubit's suspicion, Burroughs asks Cubit to open his mind to him so he can reveal Survival's intentions. In shock, knowing Survival's nefarious plans, Cubit left his presence, confirming Survival may be way worse than the Plutonian, as he confronted Android Modius, whom is being inhabited by Modius, who initially warned him about Survival, and in irritation, Cubit scolded him not to gloat, for he is forcing Cubit to go in search for the Plutonian as he bring him back to Earth to balance power with the Survival by using a zombified Skylar to kidnap Kaidan. No matter the misgiving Cubit has towards Modius' android, whom is being inhabited by Modius, Cubit knows he is right, but secretly, he took the bullet that can kill the Plutonian with him, just in case there is a threat to his life from the unpredictable Plutonian, for he was part of the people who facilitated in the Plutonian's exile. Waking up from his constructed fantasy and not knowing where he is, he accidentally chopped up the hands of one of the residents of Genome with his fingernail. Knowing he has his strength back, crashed out of the facility he was in and demanding to know where he was. A voice answered him, Genome. Shocking to the Plutonian, it was the Cape Crusader in his constructed fantasy, Auroran. Questioning who Auroran was and asking him if he was the one whom had locked him in this prison. But Auroran replied him by telling him that he was not in a prison, but in an intergalactic asylum at the center of the sun, and no one has ever escaped it.